a fellow photographer came out from one of my Colorado workshops, and he's a Sony shooter. I got to use some of his Sony gear, and it was actually really impressive stuff. We went out to one of the coolest places in western Colorado, one of my favorites, Yankee Boy Basin. We went out to shoot some wildflowers and some landscape stuff, but we actually found something totally cool that I wanted to share with you. So come on, let's go check it out. So I'm back at Yankee Boy Basin. I made a video here a couple weeks ago to show you the landscape beauty, but we came back for a very specific thing, which I'll show you in a minute. But this hill right behind me, it looks just like a big rock pile, but it's not. It's actually home to a family of marmots and a really cute little teeny pika. And I've got some, there's the pika now. He just ran down the rocks here in the front. And there's a marmot up top in the flowers. I'm gonna get some pictures and video. This fuzzy creature is a marmot, a yellow-bellied marmot to be exact. And that giant rock pile is where this one and quite a few others live. They vary in size and weight, and I believe these two are younger ones. Marmots live in colonies where there is one dominant male, and here he is now, proudly sitting on top of the rock pile. I would say this is definitely the king of the hill, although posing among beautiful wildflowers isn't exactly a masculine trait, but I really don't think this marmot has any issues lazily claiming his territory in the beautiful surrounding flowers. I mentioned another animal living here as well, and that was the pika, or pika, I'm not sure how you pronounce it. This was my first time seeing this cute little fuzzball, and it didn't stick around for long, but I did manage to get this one shot before it disappeared into the rock pile. All of the wildflowers that are beautifully sprinkled throughout this amazing terrain attract more than fuzzy animals and tourists with cameras. They also attract one of my favorite creatures, the always incredible hummingbird. This beauty was busy getting nectar from this amazing group of Indian paintbrush flowers. I managed to get a few shots of this awesome bird as it effortlessly hovered from flower to flower. I never get tired of watching these amazing birds, and I have a full featured video in the works dedicated to just these incredible birds. Keep your eyes open for it soon. All of that hovering from flower to flower is tiring. This little bird decided to rest for a minute on this old dead tree branch, the perfect lookout perch to keep an eye on its territory. And look at the magnificent iridescent colors on this bird. The feathers look like they're made from shiny pieces of colored metal and jewels. And check out that beak. The entire top half is covered in golden colored pollen from that Indian paintbrush. And now I guess it's nap time for this gorgeous little bird. And it's amazing to see how well modern cameras like the D850 and that 500mm f4 lens resolve such fine detail on this bird's tiny little feathers. As if this place isn't beautiful enough, there's this awesome waterfall right here, which I'm sure you can hear. And they always joke about there being like treasure hidden behind the waterfall. And this one, there really is a treasure hidden right behind the waterfall. And it's so cool, I gotta show you. So what's so special about this waterfall? Well, it just flew by. Here, let me change the camera angle and focus your attention in the upper right corner right here. And then I'm going to start the video in 3, 2, 1, go. So, what was that gray streak of feathers that disappeared into the shadows on the left? That was a fleeting glimpse of the only true aquatic songbird in North America, the American Dipper. But I'm not going to leave you sitting there with that far off, hard to see shot. That's not what I'm about. Let's see if we can get a little closer to this bird so we can actually see what it looks like. That's much better. And how cool to see the bird perched on top of the waterfall. And here's yet another shot where the bird is perched on a nice wet rock right under the waterfall. But let's see if we can get a good close-up shot. There we go. Now we can really see this amazing bird and its catch, which is apparently some kind of insect. But I keep saying this bird is amazing. It doesn't really look amazing though, does it? I mean, it's about as plain as you get when it comes to birds, but sometimes animals are amazing because they do amazing things. In this shot, it almost looks like the bird is looking for something, but what could it possibly be looking for? I mean, it's perched high up on the ledge. The only thing right below this bird is that icy cold pool of water at the base of the waterfall. I did mention that this bird was an aquatic bird, didn't I? Aquatic bird standing on a ledge over a cold pool of water at the base of a beautiful waterfall? And speaking of waterfall, let's just take a second to sit back, relax, and soak in the beauty that is this waterfall. Wait, did that bird just dive headfirst into the water? Let's rewind that and play it again. And here it comes now, right into that cold mountain water. When this bird hits the water, a special eyelid called a nictitating membrane covers its eye so that it can still see while it's swimming. It's like having a built-in pair of swimming goggles. It also has scales that close off its nose so no water gets in. Now that is amazing. I sat and watched this bird do this over and over again. At one point, it just gingerly swam to the edge before gracefully diving into the water and vanishing into the turbulent foam at the base of the falls. This bird had its own little slice of paradise. So what is this bird doing down there? Well, it was busy collecting food. And it wasn't collecting food for itself either. This pair of American dippers, yes, there's a pair, they have a family tucked away in the shadows right next to the waterfall. And if you can't see the babies in the shot yet, you will in 3, 2, 1, it's snack time. Look at those bright colored mouths. Now we know why the adults have been so busy. Let's see if we can get some pictures of these babies. And here they are now with a face only a mother could love. This was a challenging shoot because these birds were deep in a shadow. I shot at f5 because I was dealing with a relatively flat subject. There's not too much depth going on here. I used a shutter speed of 1/400th of a second handheld, and I used plus 0.7 exposure compensation to help light up those shadows. Auto ISO helped manage the ISO, so making adjustments to the exposure compensation was really only changing the ISO value for me. The slower shutter speed made it a little difficult to freeze the movement and handhold the big 500 f4, but I managed to get a few great shots of an adult feeding those fuzzy-headed chicks. Once the chicks are full and fed, one of the adults squeezes into the nest and gets cozy. But wait a minute, something isn't right here. One of the babies has gone to the bathroom. And when these babies go to the bathroom, it comes out in its own little carrying case. And that's right, it's the parent's job to carry the poop out of the nest. But here's the interesting part. The adults take it down to the water and toss it in, which in a way completes the food chain. The adults feed their young things like larvae and small fish that live in the water. The babies eat the larvae and small fish. And then the adults carry the baby's poop back down to the water and drop it in, where the cycle starts all over again. Kind of gross, but that's how things work. And remember this next time you find a fresh mountain stream and decide to dip your hands in the water to either drink it or cool your face. Your mountain oasis could very well be an animal's toilet. What'd you think of those crazy diving birds? Man, they were amazing. So was everything else that we saw on this adventure. Let me know in the comment section below. And if you found this video helpful, share it. That's really helpful to me. And click the thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed yet, now's the perfect time. And when you subscribe, make sure you click that little bell icon. That'll tell you every time I upload a new video and you can be the first one to watch it. If you want to watch my other video on this location, there's a link to that on the screen right now. And check out my workshop schedule and my books too. They're on the screen as well. And until next time, I'll see you later.